Hitler's poodle. Next on Tyrants and Their Pets. 7:30, Thursday.
Welcome back to Newstopia. Still to come, Julia Gillard proves she's no vampire. Cambodian chia pets prove something of a curate's egg. And four-week anniversary of Marcel Marceau's death marked by a minute's conversation. And Lindy Spurn joins us now with a look ahead in tonight's sport.
It sure was, Sean. Whether it was rugby league, cricket or the Ironman triathlon, it was a fantastic weekend for Australia, with victories in New Zealand, India and Hawaii. Details later in the bulletin.
If only victory in Iraq was that easy. A rise in the incidence of street violence has community groups up in arms. Boston Roberts takes up the story.
Gangs of youths, out of control and on the rampage. This footage, captured on a mobile phone camera, begs the obvious question, where are the parents? A little surprisingly, they're just metres away. The popular view is that the rise in youth violence is the fault of parents who couldn't care less what their children are doing. But Bill and Elaine Durham don't fall into that category. On the contrary, they claim to take a keen interest in their son's activities.
We always make sure that he looks his best and that his weapon is well maintained. That's looking good today.
That's nice.
But some sections of the community are appalled by the behaviour of people like Bill and Elaine Durham. Again, the obvious question is, where are their parents? Community groups say that while Bill and Elaine are ironing gang clothing or polishing samurai swords, their parents, Albert and Sarah Durham and Hugh and Gwen Swing, are just sitting around on their asses dribbling and babbling, completely oblivious to the mayhem caused by their fornication, or words to that effect. And that until willful miscreants like these are made to take responsibility and pull these gangs into line, our streets will continue to be unsafe. Boston Roberts, Newstopia.